mother, you know, the mother has to make it work. Like, why is it always left up to the woman to make these things right when they're fucking wrong? Like, how, why is it so much on us? Like, how did we become so strong? Because now, in the same instance, right, I get the child support from him, you know, like y'all all know. This week I didn't get it. So I'm like, well, damn. On a week when I need it, you know, it's Easter weekend, I have plans for the kids, I don't get the money. I'm like, fuck. I done wrote the cable people a check thinking that they wasn't going to take it out till like 2 days later. They done took their money out sooner. $250 I thought I had. I'm like, oh, shit. They done took that out too. Like, fuck. Look how good God is. I was like, damn, I ain't going to have nothing. My accountant called me last night to tell me that my stimulus check came. Like, I didn't know it was going to be there at the moment. But I'm sitting here about to be a little stressed, you know, taking my last, because I already done spent $250 to take the kids to go somewhere. Now I got to get their clothes and have a little spending money. What the fuck, babe? I'm, you know, I've been getting a little money from this bum. Now I ain't got. Nigga, what the fuck you did that I ain't get the child support this week, the holiday weekend? And we just seen you, like, so you adding a double. We ain't even tell me, like, you done seen you done walk past us, and we ain't even get the money. But you probably, I bet you planning, you know, like something for the little Easter for these motherfuckers, but the one that's actually yours, we got to stuff, and guess what? As me being a mother, I got to suck that up. I got to make shit right. I got to make it happen, regardless if that shit came through or not. Mommy was already in the mall before she even called. Because I got the check. I have a check. It ain't cash. I have a check. I still need the money. My plans is for tomorrow. I still had to make it work. Oh, thank God I got a little business going on where I got money in that account, which I'm not supposed to touch. But for my kids, if I got to do it, I got to do it. I just got to put it back. But I got to make all these motherfucking adjustments, because now when it's time for me to show my accountant, she got to say, Toy, you was in Jimmy Jazz, you was in Foot Locker. Mm-hmm. That wasn't for the girl. Listen, I needed it. I put it back. Right. I got to go through all this shit
just to make it
work for my kids while dad is like, why is it that we are like fucking superwoman, like.
I think that's just what it is. That's just what we are. We're nurturers. We are those beings, and it's a tough role that we have. It's a lot of things that we have to put on our shoulders and our backs sometimes. But like I was gonna say before I get sidetracked, I commend you by how you handled it, and I told you this when we was talking, but I definitely commend you on how you handled yourself when you was in that supermarket, because yes, everything in my body would have ripped. Oh,
crazy. God. Reaction. I'm not thinking about
that. Stand up. So the fact that you was able to hold yourself together, think about your kids, and just what could happen after if you reacted a certain way. Like, I just commend you for that. So, for that. And also, I wanted to say my personal opinion. I think you need to start not caring about what the homeboy got going on. I think you need to really get into a place where, you know what, my kids is good. I make sure they eat. I make sure their clothes is good. They in school. They doing what they supposed to do. I'm doing as a woman, as a female, as their mother. I'm showing them about business, how to own a business, how to have a business, how to do certain things to make life better for everyone, future goals.
See, that's a cut you off, but you older than me. So you've been there and done that. Like, that's that strong woman. That's like my mother saying, I don't want to be strong all the time. I want to be weak. I want somebody to do it for me. Like, I'm tired of doing everything for everybody. I helped my mother with my brother. I'm there for my grandmother. Like, I'm there for my mother. I'm there for my kids. I'm there for friends. Like, I don't want to, like, no. Can somebody do for me and then to put me, girl, I want another little baby? To put me in a position to have a baby.
Wait, a
and you don't even got mommy or daddy to be like, I'm ready to make a fuck you right here. He over there with your mama. No, this motherfucker stuck. He with me. He with me. 24/7. He with me. He is with me. If he not with me, he with my grandmother. Like, he still with me, because then they calling me all fucking day. He wants his mom. Like, so I'm never getting a relief. So sometimes it's like, it's overwhelming. Not saying like, like, I'm not going to give up, but it's like, why is it expected to just be like, girl, you got it. Just go. You got it. No, I don't.
That's how I ended up here, because, like, Lo would tell you, like, the day before we met, I was right there. Literally at a point where it was just like, why do you pour so much into people? And then it's like, you don't get no resolve. I told him, and I said it several times, I feel alone standing next to the black man, whoever that is, or even in the black community, because either, like, you're forced into a position where you have to be strong, so you gotta find time or find people that you can be vulnerable with, which is fucking draining, because we're human, and we're meant to feel whatever we're meant to feel naturally without being boxed into somebody else's thought process. So, like, the draining factor, it is, like, we are forced to be mothers to our children and everybody else. Niggas that we meet, friends that we come across, our parents, our siblings, and then, like, we're forced into a business role because either our attitude, our whatever, is not professional enough to stay in your field, and then we still gotta feed these kids. It's fucking draining.
But I feel, personally, like, I have a regular 9-to-5. I'm married. I have children. Trying to do my own business thing. All of that is time consuming. Like, this whole weekend, I'm going to be working doubles. So I'm, like, not going to really see my weekend. It's going to be gone. But then when I get home, I still got to make a little bit of time for my kids. I still got to talk to my husband, spend a little bit of time for him, you know. And in the midst of all of that, and I know it's not easy. I know it's not easy. But in the midst of all of that, you have to find, even if it's an hour out of your day, just for you, even if you go in the bathroom, you just sit in the bathroom just by yourself, just to think, just to go to clear your head, just to release all of that for a moment, just so you can continue with the rest of your day. I can't say you're going to have a whole weekend to yourself. I'm not going to say you're going to have a whole 24 hours to yourself, because that may not be what you get, but you have to learn to separate yourself at some point from everybody, children, family, friends, everybody, and just make it about you.
A lot of people get locked into the routine because the kid will tell you, like, the last 24 hours has been on the road. Like, yesterday, it gets, that sounds beautiful, like, the idea of it, but some people's reality, like, maybe hers and definitely mine, is the last 24 hours of our day has been, I woke up yesterday at 10:30 to drive to the Bronx, went from the Bronx to Pennsylvania to pick my son up, came from Pennsylvania, went for the house, washed his hair, took him to Long Island to the skating rink, came back to my mother's house, picked up some clothes, went back to my house, got 3 hours of sleep to get back up to drive back to Pennsylvania, halfway upstate before I'm rerouted because of work, to Pennsylvania to come straight here. We had snacks. It's not, like she said, it's not fair that even in that, you can't just accept that this is a fucking lie. Like, I can't show him, like, this is too much. Like, I wanted to check out 4 hours ago. I wanted to go to sleep and go back home 4 hours ago. I didn't want to go through half of what we went through hours ago, because if I do that, then what am I showing you? It's a lie. If we can do it, I'm not saying that it's impossible, but it's like, where do we leave our mental at that point when we're forced to, let me squeeze a 35-minute chill session after 48 hours of
the same way you squeeze having a business. No, not so much like how. It's like
the time that you took for your other personal things that you want to get into, your career.
It's not so much like the how. Like, because you could always squeeze it in. It's like, but where does that leave your mental? It's like, I literally left my what I'm left with is the little time that I can squeeze in for myself. Because the rest of my existence is for everybody else. You can do it, but I mean, what the fuck that's saying about, like, how am I supposed to feel about that?
It's a personal. I can't tell you how you're gonna feel about it. I know the little hour or so that I might take for myself, it helps. It makes me all right to be able to deal with whatever else is going on, whatever craziness might happen. So I can't speak for you personally how you would be able to incorporate that into your life. But for you to say that it couldn't be done,
I don't think it's like an hour of relaxation. An hour for me is I'm decluttering my brain. My brain is not shut off.
It could be something small. Like instead of taking a shower, you take a bath. You know what I'm saying? Like your bath time could be, you know, your regular time that you would spend.
We're gonna do something a little different. We're talking about ghetto situations, like hood situations, like there is no bathtub. There is no,
You make every situation
I'm not making it. I'm just saying sometimes that's people's life. And if you want to be honest, that's my life. I don't have access to a bath.
Okay.
My life is not set up right now that I can just go and run a bath.
But those are examples.
No, but like this is what I'm saying.
Whatever
like,
you have.
But what she's saying is
this is people's situation.
Completely different.
It's easy to say, okay, if I have an apartment, I can run a bath. If I have a house, I can run a bath. If I have anything where it's mine, I can do.
That's
everybody
not
don't
escape,
have that.
Escape.
And then even if you have okay, I'm going to go and put on some meditative music because that thing works for me. And then as soon as you do that, it's... And these things are not so that you can literally ignore because the pain in the ass behind that door can literally fuck your entire life. So it's like, my escape becomes driving in the car. Driving in the car is a burden because you gotta pay for gas. There's red lights, traffic, police. So what do you do in a situation like she said?
If you find an issue with everything, then I don't know. Like, only thing I can do is try to come up with solutions to maybe better the situation. But if you have a counter to everything that's being said, then it's hard to argue. Like right now, I don't know.
Some people's life are literally a counter. Like where I can tell her, like, you can do this. In her mind, she don't have a tub. So that don't work. If I tell you that,
but
you can do this,
but look at the main point of it is forget the tub and the shower and the bath. Forget that. It's just the whole point is to have some type of time and space just for yourself. Just for yourself, mentally. You're saying that
can't
be done.
And I
disagree. I feel like everyone can make some kind of time for themselves so that they can be able to function and get on with the rest of their day. Because everybody has chaotic days.
I think everybody...
things going on.
I think everybody might have the capability of learning to do that if they're put in the position to do that. I can never generalize and say everybody has the opportunity to make time for themselves. That is not everybody's day. Some people literally go from one job to the next job to the next job to the next job, wake up, go to sleep, go back to work. The time that they might get is in the shower when they're washing their ass, using the bathroom, or getting dressed for the day.
But if that's sufficient for them.
But that's the sufficiency.
If someone's workload is so much more than their peace,
yes, they can get there 15 minutes, but then we still end up here. I'm not saying that what you're saying is incorrect. I'm saying I'm here. I do the 15. We can do this. It's not fair, and it's not enough that the workload is literally on overdrive, and I can barely squeeze breathing room. And that's why I can, like, look at her face. Like, it's draining. Like, she's drained. And then it's the insult to injury. It's draining. I understand that, but I also feel as
it's
us,
fucking,
as us mothers, we are who our kids look to. We're the role models. And
that's my
it's
fear.
Like, I don't know. I don't see the knocking. I don't see that we should feel so defeated. If anything, we should feel the opposite because we was able to handle all of this. All these things is thrown at us at one time, and we dodging, everything is still getting done. So why feel so?
Did it like after this whole shit, man? I cried. I've been going through this for him since September, the end of September 2019. We in fucking April 2020. This nigga still giving me a run for my money, right? So I've been going through this for over a year, like a year and a half, right? The whole year of 2020, I will tell you that I cried. It wasn't a day I didn't cry. If it was from the morning, if I didn't cry in the morning, I cried that night. It was somewhere throughout the day during that year that I cried. It was so hard. Then I even cried like when good things happened because I didn't even expect it. Like, it was fucking hard from me not having a car, then for me getting a car, and then now it's like, wow, I didn't have my car for a whole year with a car note, with no job. Like, I done made it. We didn't get put out. I got the cable. I done celebrated Christmas, birthdays, you know, all holidays, Thanksgiving. I done fucking did a whole gift bag to the shelter for fucking Christmas. Like, you understand? Like, so certain, like, I literally cried, like, through the joy, like, from God, and then, like, damn, to even know, like, I went through this, a person who didn't ask for none of this, a person who gave my all to this person, who would give my all to anybody. Like, sometimes you can't, like, don't get me wrong, because I am strong and because I love the fuck out of my kids, I will never fall. Like, I will never. They gonna see me cry. They gonna see me motherfucking fight too. Right. Oh, right. This bitch is up? Okay, y'all got her tight? Watch what she do. Right. They know that. Right. Mommy's coming. It ain't no fronting on mommy. Right. Mommy's coming, but they don't know the fight that I go through to keep this shit, and I didn't have them by myself. Like, that be the hard part. Like, yeah, we gonna get it done, but look at how many women kill themselves and kill the fucking kids. Look at how many women just fucking check out, period. The nursing home, like, how many fucking people suffer nervous breakdowns, aneurysms, fucking dying in their sleep, heart attacks and all this shit. Like, that should be a lot. That shit do be a lot, and everybody don't have a go-to. Everybody can't sit in the shower. Everybody can't call somebody. Like, you got to deal with that shit.
Some people be strung out on drugs because of it. Some people got addictions because of it. Some people are homeless because of it. So all the beautiful answers that we can come up with because we put ourselves in a position to not get a certain type of fucked up, that don't apply to people who really go through shit. And it's rock hard place and someone stomping my face into the two of them.
But then if you coming to me with it, we gonna try to work something out. Like, I'm not gonna be able to hear your story and not help. We gonna try to come up with solutions. I'm not gonna keep you stuck in that area. Wherever you are mentally, and I'm not gonna keep you stuck there. We trying to figure out the next plan so we can get to the next level and things can get better for you. So everyone does have different.
Where do you think? Because I think what we're all saying is you have to have some kind of a support system or find.
It helps.
Where do people like? Okay, we're gonna take a worse situation. A homeless woman who just might have got put out with her kids or whatever. She's looking for maybe in a shelter at this point. Where do we go? Like, where are we hiding, so to speak? You know what I'm saying? Where all the good men hiding at?
Yeah.
Where all the people that support folks hiding at? Like, how do I get in contact with somebody who might just, because I'm human and because I have an experience that might relate to something that just makes sense to relate to, go to find, like, hey, I'm seconds from losing my shit. And I don't have no friends.
They do have lifelines. That's for one. Not a lot of people would want to
go that route because they don't want to tell their story.
But then it's exactly, but so then now it's like the comfortability. Like, mm-hmm. So now it needs to be people that look like you.
Us, right.
Like, that can help and to be like, girl, I went through that.
I mean, but I don't think it's going to just come up to you. I think if you're looking for that kind of help, I think it's out there. You just have to find it. Social media is right there. We got our phone access to everything.
Yeah, but then how many times on social media you see people help people? Look, they go to a homeless person and you got your camera in their face.
No, you feel the vibes. When you dealing with a certain type of business or you get in contact with a certain person, you feel the connection if it's going to work or not. And if this particular place or this program ain't rocking, you don't feel comfortable, you go on to something else. But the point is to get better, to do better. So, I mean, I know it's not easy. And I know for somebody who may have nobody, may not even have kids, they may just have themselves, no family, and it's just them, and they're trying to figure out what to do.
Two questions. Do you think talking to yourself is healthy?
I do.
And then do you think that talking to people...
Don't respond. Okay.
No, let me tell you something, because y'all going to look at me like I'm stupid. I have whole conversations with myself. I have both sides. I'll put myself in a position to have a conversation with me, with you, the two, and I'm answering for you. Because I know my levels are crazy, I guess. Like, I know what my triggers are. So before I go and address a situation that might be confrontational, that might come a certain type of way, I'm going to have the entire discussion, and we're going to play every side and see how many different ways it go wrong or right. And if it keep going left, we're not talking about it.
But sometimes you can't go by that
Now, talking to yourself would be like, don't do that, girl. Don't fucking
It's not
do
even
that,
working.
Girl. Stop playing yourself. Or like, girl, go for it. You got it. Like, and if it don't happen, you're going to try it again.
The one is like, no, bitch, but she tried it.
Because yeah.
I do that. Like, I'm a reaction type of person. Like, I'm a, like you said, beautiful flower, plenty of teeth everywhere, bitch. And just like... But you hit this thing so many times. We start having conversations in here. Then it'd be like, okay, you pop up the seed, bitch, like, listen, just give them a chance. And then they'll pop up like, no, in the face. Right now. And then they discuss things amongst themselves. And they get back to me. And that's the best, that's my quiet. That's when I'm just like, I'm going to let you say what you're saying. I might do one of these things. And literally just lock my entire system in this stance and just let them debate. And hopefully if she win, I'm just going to walk away one time.
And see, if now if that's a conversation, if we're having a conversation and you do that, I'm going to stop talking.
No.
Because now you tense.
I'm not
getting you.
No.
That means you got a wall up right now, so I'm not going to reach you. So I'm going to stop talking at that point once I see you do that.
You got shit on me.
Hold up now.
Cool.
Listen, I told y'all one thing. I stay the fuck in the house because I only get along well. And shut the fuck up. Situations like this, I'm very particular about my energy and where it's going and the sources that might trigger that shit to go left. So I'm only good in situations like this. We could fuck with each other, laugh and give it up and whatever. We can talk about whatever.
So we can't take you in the street.
Bitch, we can't. What you're telling me is don't invite me to a situation where it's like you want me to respond correctly. No. My son just gave me a story in the car about something that might have happened now weeks ago, and my brain played it out. You said something, and I'm going to do X, Y, and Z before anything clicks in. I don't want to be put in situations where I have to play the politically correct race role.
Okay, no. You're talking about just like a going out for brunch or something. Like, you can't go outside?
I can go outside, but again... Please just
no. It's brunch. Who the fuck you gonna fight with? The waiter?
I'm not saying fight. I'm not walking around looking for fights. I'm not, but what I don't like is being uncomfortable. Like, if I go to a place where it's like they're not used to.
But see, that's when you gotta know who your friends are.
But that's the thing.
So you know,
and that's what I'm telling you,
who to match with who.
I'm trying to tell you.
Because not everybody can cook together. So that's a case.
I'm not one of those friends.
Thank you for letting me know.
But it's like with other friends, or you mean like the atmosphere, like the restaurant?
I don't like ignorant shit. Like I can again, I have levels to my clique, and then once you've clicked, it's that's what the fuck it is.
It takes a lot of clicks.
Okay. It do, but certain people just know how to just be disrespectful, low key, and I don't like so. Like, you take me to a situation that's like, if you're running it, I don't like the I have a black friend situations.
Hey,
like, now you put me in a situation to realize
that. Tell me what's up. Don't it seem like. Like I'm always there when it matters, but missing most of the other time, a terrible pattern. The rewards I see from working have made me an addict. There's way more people that want it than people that have it. I don't get it, I would hate to think I tricked them. They fall victim to my system, guess I sure know how to pick them. And I'm always a regret, yeah, I'm always a regret. And I always make it harder on whoever's coming next. It goes up and down, it's just up and down. She's crying now, but she'll laugh again, cause we on the rise and she here with us. And expensive shit just keeps happening and she loves it. And she stares at me like, who does this? And we hold.